Chapter VI.
Chapter VI.
And we're back. Guys, hi. I will have this cookie now.
Nom nom cookies. This is a totally new chapter, you should not be missing this. Anyway, normally there's something behind you, and there it is. Ah.
I will take this cookie and eat it.
Well, I'll eat this LP then.
Aw, you didn't get the Death Note reference. Aw.
I don't watch Death Note.
Death Note is awesome. Like, I watched
it. It sounds like a really lame anime.
No.
Okay, so there's a crow there, but you can't get it normally, because when you walked up to it, it'll fly away, so you gotta use your new powers.
Mm.
Also, that's hell of a tornado. Or whatever you'd call that in when it's in the ocean. Whatever.
I reckon there's a tornado in Australia somewhere. Like a...
Yeah, that's, that's on the top end.
Hmm.
As we like to refer to it.
Oh, I'm all out of cookies.
I haven't got anything to snack on here, but I have tons of water. I'm being super stylish here, watch me go. Also, this level is particularly laggy, I do not know why. And it is really annoying to try and play, especially when you have the Gaze of Despair equipped. Because it already makes hitting things with everything a lot slower.
So it's just frame drop or something? Or?
I think it's just part of the game, because I think even the 360 version has this problem as well.
Well, I guess I'll find out soon enough.
So you can also dodge offset with the Panther as well. It makes it pretty useful, because if you've got really fast enemies, like Grace and Glory, makes it really easy. Super stylish.
Give me those rings.
Must have money.
She's
okay, here's a new thing. Beast-like footprints.
Unleash the beast.
Oh, but, man, of course, song. There is a thing up here.
Check it out.
I have a Dutch guy on my Facebook friends, and I do not understand most of the things he posts, because it's all in Dutch.
Well, that would make sense.
Well, yes, I just can't... I'd hate to try and read it because I'd probably butcher your language terribly.
Oh, please do. I would love to hear
oh,
that.
Oh god. Oh god. Iemand interesse in... in... Zwarte Opelkorsa?
If iemand... Ah, yeah. Okay, I kinda got what you said there. Alright. Someone interested in
language.
A black Opelkorsa. Huh.
What does that mean?
It's a car.
Okay.
If someone wants to buy it. Heeft iemand interesse?
Gotcha.
Hmm?
Do you have J's like J? Was it J like a ya sound?
Yeah, we do. Yeah.
So it's not
it's
a J. It's not a J sound.
In
yeah.
Dutch, J E is ya, yeah, and it means you.
Okay. I'm learning this.
Yeah. So are the people on the internet. Aren't you happy now?
I'm learning about the wonderful language of Dutch. Mm-hmm. So when you go to Dutchland, you can buy. I don't know, marijuana seeds and cans.
Well, it's kind of an essential phrase to know. I mean, if you walk into a coffee shop and the guy would ask, you know, that, if do you have some interest in weed or something, you would want to say yes, I guess. But if you don't understand it, I mean...
I don't know, I don't think people not knowing English is an issue in, like, the Netherlands.
No, that is true.
It's not like, say, Germany, where if you go somewhere, it's like, don't understand English.
Well, surprisingly, a lot of people in Berlin spoke English. I mean, I talked...
There was a lot more young people there. Yeah. When I was there, I was in, like, the countryside. And whenever people saw me, like, oh, you're like an Asian. That's weird.
We have never seen Asians in these parts of my country.
aren't you supposed to be in like the Chinese restaurant?
Mm-hmm.
That's essentially what I'm here for, right?
I'm not even Chinese!
Isn't that the case in your town or whatever? Like, the only Asians there are like for the shop, for the restaurant?
Sadly enough, in the little town where I came from, that is the case. There's like two Asian families, and one of them runs a Chinese restaurant, and the other one, a snack bar or something. So yeah.
It wasn't us, maybe they did laundry or something.
No, we don't have those kinds of stores. We do our own
Or maybe
laundry.
A hairdresser. Like, we have a lot of hairdressers here, and most of them are Asian. But they do cheap haircuts, so you can't complain.
There's a lot of Turkish immigrants doing haircuts for some reason. I don't know why.
Huh. Don't they make like kebab shots or something?
The kebab. I love kebab. That's so nice. We'll get some later today, I guess.
Oh no, there is this thing. It's not strictly like Adelaidean where I come from, but it's pretty awesome.
Mm-hmm.
It's like this thing called an AB. And basically it's chips with gyros meat, so like you can get a combo with like lamb and chicken.
Uh-huh.
And then it's smothered in sauce, and this is the best thing. So you can ask for like barbecue sauce and tzatziki chili and sweet chili, and it is the best like hangover food ever.
I imagine it is.
It's the best. Mm.
What just happened, by the way? All the spiky things?
There was spiky, like the door closed and the spiky things happened, and then we came over and turned it off.
Yeah, there was a little girl, I think?
Yeah, we're chasing the little girl and we saw her like chapter 3.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Oh wait, chapter 2.
Why are we chasing her again?
Because Bayonetta feels like she needs to.
She will turn her into her disciple or something?
Here, I'll show you how to grow long legs and wear your hair.
Yeah.
And do this.
Oh, that's pretty neat.
Bam.
Is that a new move?
No, I just never use it because it's pretty flashy. But as I mentioned at the time, you do get invincibility frames when you start it.
Mm-hmm.
And it can be useful at times if you can't be bothered parrying or whatever.
Surprise.
It's an Alfheim, and yeah, I suppose this one's a bit hard because there's no reason you would go back here.
Wow.
Yes.
Oh, there it is. Keep talking about
this torture attack one. I didn't show it in this recording, but I did mention it the first time, is that by torture attacks, it means a torture kill.
Hmm.
So unless you kill it, it won't count the torture attack, which is pretty lame. Clusterfuck.
Poor guys.
This looks so easy now, but when I was recording it, it took me many, many tries to do this. The things I do for this LP.
Mm.
Like I said, I could just record my first time playing through and I'd still get a platinum, but it just wouldn't be as good. Torture attack for these guys different. Oh yeah, the torture attack for these guys is the same one as for the Grace and Glory.
Mm-hmm.
Although according to the Bayonetta wiki, it says she says Alcrate, which it still means fiery. I'm pretty sure it's the same sound file as the Grace and Glory attack.
Mm-hmm. Great, last one. We'll move on.
No, you can do as many as you can until like all the enemies are out.
Oh.
So here with these guys, you don't actually get one hit kills with the torture attack. Like, you only do like half damage or something. So if you do it when they're at full health, it won't count as torture attack.
Mm-hmm.
Also, I changed to the electric Dogo on the feet because sometimes this guy will do an attack which spreads electricity. And if you have the electric feet equipped, then you won't get hurt by it.
Oh, cool.
And the same works for the fire thing. Like, if you remember the chapter 3, there was the lava level.
Mm-hmm.
You can walk in lava if you have the fire Dogo equipped.
Just like a reverse Jesus or something?
Yeah, pretty much.
6 out of 5 attacks. Nice.
And then later we'll get another weapon which allows you to pretty much warp in anything.
Oh man, just thinking of this really cheesy Eurodance song. Oh man.
You're a thing you're familiar with, right?
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm supposed to be, I suppose. I should be. Do you know Milk Inc.? By any chance?
Did you say Milk Inc.?
Yes, because that's what they were called.
What the hell is Milk Inc.?
I don't know, it's some weird Belgian band. And they made all these.
Well, yeah, you can
bands.
Use milk as an ink if you, like, write in it and then, like, burn the paper or something.
No, no, Milk Inc., like, incorporated.
Oh, right. I think
that's still
and, like,
evil.
Yeah.
It's still. I mean, they're from Belgium.
Milk Incorporated, why?
I hope there's not any Belgians watching, by the way. Oh well.
Oh, they probably are. I get some viewers in, like, Europe somewhere. I don't know. According to YouTube.
YouTube. Well, I'm guessing if it's very popular in Holland, I will be responsible for that, I guess. My 3 views or
yes.
something?
Yes. Fighting these guys on the stairs is the worst, because the camera does not like stairs.
Stairs, my one weakness!
Like, for the most part, the camera is pretty good, but this. It just sometimes gets stuck on the dumbest thing, like the wall or whatever. And then enemies get a free hit and you.
Uh-huh. Oh man, you should never play Beyond Good and Evil then. It's a great game, but camera sucks! Oh.
Well, didn't it get a HD re-release recently?
I think it got a release a month back or something on Xbox Live and PlayStation Store.
Yeah, PlayStation came a bit after,
mm-hmm. I mean, I would recommend playing it because it's a really cool game.
I think people would be really waiting for a sequel for that or something.
Mm-hmm.
I watched an LP of it, that one was particularly good.
It's kind of like a cult classic, I think, Beyond Good and Evil. I played it when it came out, and now I'm playing it again, but I still like it.
Yeah, that's a good sign.
I kind of hope they're going to make a second one, but I'm guessing not.
Well, haven't they sort of been... I'm pretty sure they've been teasing people with, like, you know, screenshots or whatever, like, a possible second one.
Mm-hmm. I think there is a teaser trailer out there somewhere, but I'm not sure if they're actually going to make it. No.
Like, people have been asking Kamiya to make a Bayonetta 2. Like, I'm not sure what a Bayonetta 2 would consist of.
Story wise, or
what? I would buy the ship.
No.
If the combat is as good as this.
No, most studios will just. Oh, new Call of Duty! Yay! More monies.
Why do you keep buying the same shit?
Mm-hmm. I will probably end up playing it, because I just want to know the story, but... Oh well.
There's a story in those games? Really?
Yeah. But usually it's like, you know, oh, kill these guys. They're Arabs, and they're foreign terrorists, and you have to kill them.
Well, that sounds kind of similar to, like, Uncharted.
Hmm.
Like, Drake pretty much just goes everywhere and just kills people because they're shooting at him. It's like, self-defense.
Yeah, exactly. I'm guessing you don't play Black Ops?
No, I don't play that sort of shit.
It's a really lame story. So you're
like, that's an
to this chair, and then people start shouting at you, you know, what are the numbers, Mason? Tell me the numbers. And you're like, I don't know the numbers, man. And then you have to play all these kind of weird missions and you have to kill Fidel Castro. And it's like, okay, that's cool.
And that what?
Was, yeah. Because you're replaying your memories, like literally. Huh.
Okay.
Yeah, Black Ops is a strange game. Well, hi. Nah, it's a different studio. Why am I talking about Black Ops? More cutscenes.
Yep.
What are you boys doing in here?
Those aren't boys. Those are demons.
Are you hiding something from me? Come on.
Yes, smack that ass.
You know, I reckon really you should do some time where you just have like shots lined up every time I see your ass.
Mm. I think he was pretty drunk by the end of that.
That would make for the best commentary. Although I don't know.
Cool.
I don't think I'd be the last one with 5 shots.
Oh! 4 shots.
Someone else caught your eye?
She got bitch slapped with a gun.
Yep. Pistol whip.
Something tells me I'm going to regret this.
Why do you ask?
Trippin' balls! I don't know what the hell's going on, but I'll listen to this voice anyway.
Oh, I was like, that girl has an unsurprisingly low voice.
Well, she's telepathically putting that into her head, like, yes. My dear sweet child, I'm the way to the future.
Can't touch this. Do crotch shots count too?
Yeah, we should totally count crotch shots because there's a lot of them too. Should we do that next time? I reckon we should do that next time. At least I'll have like a bowl of something. I can have like a finger of it too.
Yeah, the thing is, it's kind of midday here, so I would be drunk the whole day. I'm guessing that.
Well, you could be drunk on like, you know, a Saturday, can't you?
Yeah, I guess.
Afternoon. It's totally okay. Or else we could wait till 6 in the morning again.
Huh, there's a spider crawling up my wall. Hello, spider.
Probably can't tell in this, but this entire level was really laggy, and it was really hard to play this.
Because of the camera, maybe?
Well, not because of the camera, because the actual gameplay was just really laggy.
This camera's annoying sometimes.
At that point, it comes up to chance when, like, if you get hit or not.
Mm.
Oh, I guess I should mention, like, this fight afterwards, you get a trophy for it if the girl doesn't get hurt. The trophy slash achievement is called A Mother's Love.
Wow. Speak for you trophy slash achievement whores out there. Listen.
Oh yeah, the more observed of you guys would notice I did a pretty cool move there where you dodge. You offset the combo by using the taunt button. That's a pretty pro move there, and you'd never ever use it normally. But I was being fancy.
Oh, you show off.
Well, I gotta show off everything.
Mummy! My mummy! Oh god! My mummy! Mummy!
Oh god. I know I had a lot of like late nights and drunk and everything, but I'm pretty sure I'm not a mummy.
Yeah, I'm clearly not a mummy. God damn, this one ugly child, by the way.
No, but
yeah,
she's
shoot
so
her.
Cute. She's so cute, though. Look at her.
She has like these stupid Harry Potter glasses.
Well, a crying baby cockroach would be true. Well, they need to be like taped up in the middle.
So don't you dare cry.
And they don't have any lenses, so she's clearly a poser.
Hmm. Don't you dare cry.
Fine.
I'll put a bullet between those eyes.
You've got to be a strong little one to survive in a place like this.
I will train you now!
What's your name,
no?
I will train you the ways of being a slut.
Sabessa.
Excuse me, she's not a slut.
Oh,
Sarissa.
You're not from Figreed, are you, little one? Where are you from?
I'm from my house.
Well now, I'll hazard a guess this isn't your home. So what on earth
My daddy told me to come here.
Your dad told me to go to the creepy place and... What kind of a dad would say that?
The drunk dad who doesn't take care of his kids.
I can't just drag you along wherever I go, little one. So you'd better not be getting attached to me.
Yes, mommy?
I will slap you now.
Come now, little one. I'll help you out of here. But that's all.
Yes! Oh man, it's about time someone did that.
I mean, you kind of wonder, you know, all these ribbons in her hair. Like, why don't they get tangled up more often?
Mm-hmm.
It's why everyone needs that personal fan, to make sure their hair doesn't get tangled.
Yeah.
Nah.
Will she follow you around like a Pikachu?
Yeah, she's kind of like an escort mission now, except you don't need to escort her, she'll just follow you everywhere. And she is positively tiny.
Mm-hmm. Well, Bayonetta has ridiculously long legs, so maybe she's not tiny. Maybe she's just very long. Tall.
Well, Bayonetta had some leg lengthening surgery. You know, there's that extra 5 centimeters really helped.
Uh-huh. Guessing she has an extra set of kneecaps or something. He's like triple.
Kind of like a bird, you know, how they like double jointed at the feet. That is like a really shocking image. Of a Bayonetta with double jointed feet.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, here you have to hit them with the light pole because they're in the other dimension.
Oh.
And because you're with Sarazer, you can't go into the other dimension, so you have to use like a light pole to hit them. And I was being extra twitchy here because, my god, they hit fast.
Uh-huh.
And the pole is really slow.
Wow. Sinister.
Oh god.
So, if they're in another dimension, how can you throw, like, real objects at them?
The explanation is in the documentation, is that it says that while you have 3 different dimensions, you can actually... If you break an object in one world, they will break in all the worlds. So I guess that means translates to... All objects can interact in all levels.
Huh.
So if you chuck things at them... That will hurt them. That's my very loose understanding of it.
Mommy!
So that guy can hurt you. It just doesn't happen very often. Lose some weight, you fatty. You fatty. There's an airport nearby.
Purgatorio.
So there's a bird there, but you can't get that one unless you use the panther. And it's kind of annoying to get for me.
Mm-hmm.
I had to cut a lot of it out. As you'll see, there's a cut here at some point.
Oh.
There you go. Yeah, I cut out about a minute of me trying to get a dumb bird.
You fucking bird. Ah, I got it.
Yeah.
Well, that was a lot faster.
And no, she can't go down into the pub with you, she's underage.
You bring me enough of these halos.
Oh yeah, this is the first time we actually see him outside of giving him an LP. I guess those little comments at the beginning are meant to be like references to other games.
Like Halo? Like
Bold,
maybe?
Yeah, Bold Space Marine is Halo and, you know, any other sort of thing. So yeah. So yeah, now we have new techniques like the bird and the moth or whatever. So we have the bat and the crow. And when you're by the crow, you get Umbran Spear, which I don't use all that often, to be honest. And we have enough money for this one. That accessory. Most people will probably love that accessory, yeah. But I will be showing off that accessory, hopefully. And a moon pearl, because magic is important.
Cruelly disfigured by unnatural means. Could just throw a whatever at it.
Huh. Throw a car at it.
Yeah.
That's unnatural.
So, Sarisa. Oh, there she is. Oh, it's like she can't come with you.
No, when you have portals like that, then yeah, she can come.
Hello, doggy.
That's probably how you got lost to begin with.
Oh shit. Oh. Oh, those guys again.
Mommy.
Don't worry. It's always scary the first time you see them. So, where was I? Oh, yes. Your kind invitation. I do hope you've prepared dessert as well.
Do all English people talk like that?
I don't know any English person people, but I'm pretty sure they don't talk like that. I remember reading a YouTube comment about how that kid's ear should have been blasted out of hell for having that.
Her eardrums should be destroyed.
Shattered.
Now.
Like, my ears are bleeding, mommy.
Cereza, my dear. Watch and learn.
So, this fight here is kind of annoying because you've got Sereza with you. And anytime any attacks get near her, then. Ugh, you might see later. But it's really annoying fighting with Sereza there.
Damn you, Sereza, can't you just go stand like there in the corner?
Exactly, she has to follow you around, and every time any of the enemies get near her, then that happens, and it slows down the counter a bit. Kind of ruins the whole time in terms of getting your pure platinum out. And yeah, that's what happens if you scream. If the doggy screams and you miss it.
Aww. Man, that poor girl was scarred for life. Jeez.
Now she can't hear at all, but now she's like getting bombarded by these dumb dogs. Okay, so when you get shocked, you have to shake the stick, and you can't do anything else except shake the stick. Although, if you have the parry accessory equipped, then you can still parry attacks, which is pretty useful. Because most of the time, the enemy, when he screams, he'll follow up with a fireball.
Mm-hmm.
And then you can parry it back in his face. Oh yeah, here's an example of the camera being a complete bitch. Because you can't see shit when that happens.
Why isn't she dead? Jeez, got hit like by a meteor. Huh. puny human.
Your shield is no match for the power of love.
Really? Oh god.
Yes, really.
Come on.
Yes, really.
Give her back. Oh.
Get your mouth off of her. That is just gross. Sereza, you don't want to go out with a guy like that. Here, look at him. He has nipple piercings.
Mm-hmm. That's not a good sign.
Oh yeah, the crow thing. So if you double R2 or dodge in the air, you turn to the bird. If you press the kick button, you can summon those feathers around you, and they can act like projectiles, I suppose. Like I do it here, yeah. And you can hear them going quick in the background. And if you press the punch button, then they'll form some sort of, they kind of hover around you, and they can, yeah, I don't know how to describe it. But yeah, this guy's a bit of a bastard.
Uh-huh.
Like, sometimes he'll stand still, and he can summon like a fire of, like, he can rain fireballs.
Mommy, why are you naked? Oh.
Mommy isn't naked. Our love was fleeting.
You've been naughty. You hear that, little girl?
You've been naughty, girl. Oh. Yes, it is your obligatory doppelganger time.
Why? What?
Oh, you'll see. This is probably one of the better enemy introductions. And that bit there, it got really laggy. So yeah, this level in general is pretty bad for the PS3. Also, if you don't get to her in time, like if you like get hit a lot by those traps or whatever, then this happens. She gets carried away.
Oh.
She gets carried away by the mean angel. And you die. It's a special death screen. Death screen.
Yes, please. Come on, pick yes. What are you waiting for?
I was doing it for dramatic effect, excuse me. Oh, and if you select no, this will happen. It's pretty abrupt.
Nope.
Yeah, that happens. But no, that never happened, so yeah, let's get into a cutscene.
So, where did she come from?
Basically, as far as I can understand, the angels really want this girl. And, yeah, the angels are working under someone who we don't know yet. So they just get summoned to do this shit.
Uh-huh.
Are you ready to get a dance off? Because this is a dance off.
Hell yeah. Bitch, you got served. Oh. I bet there's like a ton of inappropriate comments we could make right now.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh god. Clearly a stalemate, though.
Now we must fight it out in the arena. Mm.
So I'm guessing she can do the same attacks as you can?
Very similar, but just you wait and see this.
Hello. That was funny. Got wrong in so many levels.
Hell yeah. Well, she's not doing what you think she's doing, she just touched it there and there was a bit of light. There was nothing wrong with that at all.
It was implied.
Oh yeah, here's a really annoying thing about Joy, is that each one on the field can actually clone itself once. And ideally you'd like to kill them fast before you can do that, because they're very annoying in groups. But they're basically like a genre. Oh, and there's the bat right there. Basically it extends your counter time. So it gives you more time to dodge, essentially.
Oh, I haven't seen this one yet.
This isn't a very good angle for it, but I think I'll show it later. Basically she gets tied up with that whip, and I think the tie, like the kind of knot is used that is used on her is like a Japanese one or something. And she gets put into a wooden pony. The summon for that wooden pony is Nikma, which is Behold. I was just taking my sweet time with this, okay?
Oh, Cereza's left.
Cereza's already gone through.
Damn her!
See, she can take care of herself. I don't know why she needs saving. Mm. Yes, the contrast between the witch and the lumen. Everyone hates witches.
Aww.
But you gotta give it to the witches, because they're pretty damn fierce.
And hot. Apparently.
Yeah, all the witches are really hot, long-legged women.
Well, hey, it's the...
It's mannequin piss,
hell
yes.
Yeah.
I went there.
It's like the only good thing they have.
Like you go there and it's just like, oh, it's this tiny little thing. And
exactly.
Look, there's Belgian waffles.
Oh yeah, Brussels. It's like, isn't it Antwerp? No.
Yeah, it's Brussels. I went to Brussels and I went to... Oh man. There's like a town there, like half an hour away or something, and it's like... I forget what it's called now, but whatever, it was nice there. They sold penis chocolate.
Hmm. Was it in the Dutch-speaking part or the French-speaking part?
I think it was Dutch. Yeah. I think. Maybe it was French, I don't know.
Hmm.
Mummy!
Hey!
Yes. You can pretty much tell what her lines are gonna be.
I should be a writer for this game.
Come now.
Cheshire.
Look at me. Do I look like I have any interest in children? Now making them? Well, that's another story.
Oh god, awkward boner.
Whoa.
Let's play it cool, Luca. Let's play it cool.
Idea. I mean, it might be the right idea.
Ah, you know you want to.
Right? Yeah,
you want that 500-plus-year-old pussy.
I'm glad I've been standing around waiting for you, because I knew we'd cross paths. See, the only way to reach the upper
I was going to ask you out, but then you did that awkward thing about the whole sex thing, and I don't want to talk about it anymore.
Like, yeah, no.
Quick change of subject. Mm-hmm. Shit.
The island.
Man, if I look like that in 500 years, I would...
I'm pretty sure most people would tap that if you looked like that after 500 years.
Now what?
Don't play games with me. You've worked your magic on this poor defenseless child, haven't you?
You think she is defenseless?
Sad, sick woman. You know that? I was her age when you killed my father.
Boo-hoo, you killed my father.
No. Oh my god,
maybe
you
they were killed
you?
In an alley?
You killed her parents!
Daddy, I don't like this play, let's go outside.
Come to think of it, she's better off with you. You two are more hassle than you're worth.
What?
Just keep a good eye on her, or you're going to catch hell for it. No good deed goes unpunished.
And you never know when a monster may sneak up.
Mummy, look out!
So just to make sure you know, Luca can't see those guys, but Cereza can.
Ah, why is that?
I'm not really sure at the moment.
Mummy, no!
It's very windy. I hope you guys know what that means.
Yep. Chapter
end of chapter. This pure platinum was hell to get, so be very thankful for it.
Mummy, you're the best.
I am the best, shut up.
You don't have to tell me.
Exactly. So we have a boss fight coming up. It's a pretty easy one. Because I did it in one take.
Oh. Alright.
Look at a ribbon go.
We'll be excited.
See you guys
to
next
see
time.
You.